Hello friends, welcome back to our packet tracer series. Today we are going to discuss about difference between RIP 1 and RIP 2. So let's start. First we will discuss the theory part of this one, then we will go for practical. So let's start. The difference between RIP 1 and RIP 2. Actually RIP stands for Routing Information Protocol. It is dynamic protocol. Let's discuss difference between RIP 1 and RIP 2. RIP 1 support classful network only, whereas RIP 2 support classless as well as classful network. So RIP 1, it supports the classful network only, and whereas RIP 2, it supports classful as well as classless network. Means here we cannot do subnetting, and here we can do subnetting. And it use broadcast with 255.255.255.255. And whereas RIP version 2 use multicast with 224.0.0.9. And here in RIP 1, not send subnet mask information along with the routing update. Whereas RIP version 2 send the subnet mask information along with the routing update. And it does not, RIP version 1 does not support VLSM, variable length subnet mask, whereas RIP 2 will support VLSM. And it does not support for authentication, whereas in the RIP 1, it does not support authentication, whereas RIP version 2 support the authentication. And RIP version 1 is the less secure and 2 is more secure. And RIP version 1 does not support manual route summarization, whereas RIP version 2 support manual route summarization. And then we will move to the next slide, some information about the RIP. That is, here we will see that one. RIP developed used by Bellman-Ford algorithm. RIP used Bellman-Ford algorithm. And RIP use maximum router 16. If we have more than 16 router, we cannot use RIP. And then we will move to the next point. RIP send all routing table for every 30 second. Means RIP, if we configure RIP to any router, it will send all routing protocol to the other routers every 30 second, and that routing that will give all routing information protocol. Whereas in OSPF, we will send only hello packet, and if we have any network update, we will send only that update. But RIP send all table, whatever they have, even though if it is updated or not updated, RIP will send all. So this is a drawback actually in RIP. And next one, RIP administrative distance is 120. And RIP use the metric as hop count. Means it will count how many routers. Maximum is 15 router. If we attach more than 16 router, RIP will not work. And what is the syntax for RIP 1 and RIP 2 is, RIP 1 is a router RIP network, and then we will give whatever network we are using, like 10.0.0.0, here also anything 20.0.0, and whereas the RIP version 2 use RIP router RIP, then version 2, and no auto summarize these commands, and then whatever network we are using, that one. So this is a just difference between the RIP 1 and RIP 2. In our last video, we already discussed about what is RIP and what are the routing protocol, all information. So if you missed that video, you can go to the last video and watch that one. After that, you will understand. So now this theory part finished. So we will go to the lab now. I will move to the lab now. So I will open the packet tracer. Let's start in the packet tracer. See, this is a lab scenario. I already created the lab scenario here. Here what we are using means, here we are taken the, this is our lab name, RIP version 2 lab. And our aim is to ping from this PC to this PC. And we are using two router. This is router 1 and this is router 2. And this port, we given this address as 192.168.1.1, where here as 192.168.2.1. So, and here we assign already the IP address to the computers. and here also, and here server, and that between the two routers we assign this 200.1.1.1 and 200.1.1.2. So we need to configure the interface in the router, this is all interface, and then we need to run the RIP version 2. Here in this practical I am not doing RIP version 1. Generally no one is using RIP version 1 nowadays in a companies, because that does not support subnet mask, subnetting. So for that purpose we are using RIP version 2. At least this one support the subnetting. So now I am doing the lab for RIP version 2. If you want lab for RIP version 1 also, then put your comments that you need lab a video for the RIP version 1, then I can record and I can upload in our YouTube channel. So now I will write the configuration for this one. So let me open the notepad, then we will start the configuration of that one. So let me bring here configuration as same as we do for other labs, same thing I will follow here. So let me start. I will do for the router one. First one is the router one. So what we will do, our first step is config t. I will write config t, then host name R1. I will give the host name as the R1. Host name is R1, that is router 1. Then I will give, then next one, I will go first one config t, then host name, then we will write the IP address. So if we will go for the interface, which interface, see here, we have F0 by 0 and F0 by 1. So first I will write for interface F0 by 1, F0 by 0. Then IP address, what address we have here for this port F0 by 0 is this one. So I will copy this one. I will copy this address and then I will paste in the notepad. Here this is IP address. Then what is subnet mask for this one? 255.255.255.0 and no shutdown. No shut. So this one interface is done. I will do the same thing. Let me copy this whole thing and I will paste here. And here is F0 by 1. So I will move to F0 by 1 and the IP address is this one. I will write down here 200.1.1.1. And subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. This is the two interfaces configuration is done. Now I will write the raw RIP configuration. What we will do, router RIP, then version 2, no auto summary. Then we will move to the other one. Let me write here no auto summary. No auto summary. Then we will give for the network, whatever network we are using here. I will write that network. What network we are using? We are using network ID. We need to write 192.168.1.0. This is the network ID because this is a class C. In class C, we have three network bit and one host bit. So we put whatever host bit as 0, so it become network ID. Then we need to write the second network ID. What is second network ID is 200.1.1.0. This is the second network ID. Now we will next move to second router configuration. So I will write here this one. Let me copy the same thing. So we will copy paste here for second router and we will change what we need to. I will change this one is router 2, so I will write the router 2. And here in this one, same interface, we have 192.168.2.1. So I will change this to 2.1 and this will remain same. And here this F0 by 1, we have same here, only last one is 2. So I will change. So see, this one is done. And here router RIP version 2, no auto summary, and then we need to write network. So what is network? See here, 192.168.2.1, so 2.0. Here this one done, and what else is here? 200.1.10, so this one is already there. So this is our RIP configuration already done. Now I will copy this configuration and I will paste in our router 1. So let me copy this. I will go in the router 1 in the CLI mode. Let me open this, and then this is we will write no, and this is started. Then I will go in the enable mode. Then from the enable mode I will paste here. So this, see, I pasted the host name changes already to R1, then it is assigned this IP address to this one. Then we again move to the interface F0/1 and we assign this one, and with our commands this one also done. So our router port, this is up. Then I will put enter, and then I will come outside and I will save the configuration. WR we use to save the configuration. So this is done for router 1. Now I will go for router 2. Here router 2, and before that one we need to copy and we need to paste that our command. So I will copy the our router 2 configuration which we done just now, this one, and then I will go to the router 2 and I will paste here, and then I will go here enable mode, and now I will paste the configuration. See, it changed the host name as R2, and this is the IP address already finished, and this is a router RIP version 2, no auto summary network, this one, and all it is done. Now I will save this configuration. So this two configuration is saved in the two router. Now this is our configuration. I will keep here. Our aim in this lab is we need to ping this PC to this laptop, okay, and also we will add one more aim here. We need to ping this server also. So first we will see this PC can ping or not. So I will open this one. I will go in the command prompt. I will write here ping 192.168.2.2, because this IP address is 2.2, right? This is 2.2. So I write here 2.2. I will start. Let's see, ping replies coming or not. See, replies coming. So this means our PC 192.168.1.2 now is pinging with 192.168.2.2. Now let's see 3.2.3 also pinging or not. That is our server. This is our server. I am pinging this one. See here, first one is request timeout, second one is pinging. First one go for the ARP. Now another, both are pinging. So hence proof with our lab we successfully done RIP version 2 for this one. So thank you friends for watching our YouTube series for packet tracer, and we finished the RIP version 2. So very soon we are going to EIGRP and OSPF, then we will go for other topics, then we will go for BGP, MPLI and all this one, but we will use different software. Now we are using basic software, that is packet tracer. So subscribe to our channel and like our video and share it with your friends who is working or who is looking for the video in packet tracer as well as the networking basic. So very soon we will have the other topics video. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye.